Hello friends, good morning. In today's video lecture, we are going to discuss the third poem into our poetry unit. The name of the poem is Hunger, which is written by Jayanta Mahapatra. Before going to discuss the poem, let us discuss about the poet Jayanta Mahapatra. Jayanta Mahapatra is an Indian English poet who born in Cuttack on 22nd October 1928. And he is the first Indian poet to win Sahitya Academy Award for English Poetry. He is the author of poems such as Indian Summer and Hunger, which are regarded as classics in modern Indian English literature. So we are fortunate that we are going to discuss this poem, Hunger, written by Jayanta Mahapatra, who is among the classics in Indian English literature. There is a very big contribution of Mahapatra in the literature. He has authored 27 books of poems, out of which 7 are in Odia language and rest in English language. This is all about the poet Jayanta Mahapatra. Let's move on. This is the poem, text of the poem. I would like to tell you boys and girls that before going to discuss this video, you should have your textbook in your hand. You should have the text of the poem. Just go through it. It's a poem of 4 stanzas, a bit longer poem. It was hard to believe the flesh was heavy on my back. The fisherman said, "Will you have her?" carelessly, trailing his nets and his nerves as though his words sanctified the purpose with which he faced himself. I saw his white bone thrash his eyes. Second stanza. I followed him across the sprawling sands, my mind thumping in the flesh's sling. Hope lay perhaps in burning the house I lived in. Silence gripped my sleeves. His body clawed at the froth his old nets had only dragged up from the seas. The third stanza. In the flickering dark, his hut opened like a wound. The wind was I, and the days and nights before. Palm fronds scratched my skin. Inside the shock, an oil lamp slayed the hours bunched to those walls. Over and over, the sticky soot crossed the space of my mind. And the last and the fourth stanza, I heard him say, "My daughter, she has just turned 15. Feel her. I'll be back soon. Your bus leaves at 9. The sky fell on me, and father's exhausted wife. Long and lean, her ears were cold as rubber. She opened her wormy legs wide. I felt the hunger there. The other one, the fish slithering, turning inside." So friends, this is the poem, the text of the poem, Hunger. About hunger, we can say that it has 2 meanings in the poem. The title itself is Hunger, but the hunger is of 2 types. Hunger for food, that is for stomach, and hunger for sexual gratification, a physical hunger. But in the end, the hunger transforms into the hunger of stomach that leads the people to do anything. How that leads the people to do anything, we will going to discuss in the coming slides. About the structure of the poem, we can say that the poem consists of 4 stanzas having 5 lines each, except the 6th, because 6th stanza has 6 lines. There is no set rhyme scheme into this poem. The poet uses number of poetic devices to describe the events that led from one hunger, that is sexual hunger, to the other type of hunger, that is physical. So this is all about hunger. Jayanta Mahapatra he atishay prasiddh ashe Indian writing in English madle poet manle jatat. Tyancha anek poems ahet, bareche sangrah suddha ahet, tyachyapaiki Hunger navachi poem je classic poem ingraji madhe manle jate, ti poem apan aaj abhyasnar ahot. Moving further, the summary of the poem. It is taken from Mahapatra's Rain of Rhymes. This is the name of the collection of his poems. And Hunger is extracted from Rain of Rhymes, and it is telling and revealing about the degraded condition of the people who live below the poverty line. This is the important theme of the poem, degraded condition of people in India. Further, we can say that it explores the degradation of humanity given the difficulty of poverty, and speaks volumes for what a human being can fall away in a state when that next meal is doubtful. अत्यंत गरिबी जर असेल तर कुठल्या प्रकारची वेळ लोकांवर येऊ शकते आणि लोक कुठल्याही थराला जाऊ शकतात, हे अतिशय करुण अशा प्रकारचं वास्तव या कवितेमध्ये समोर आणण्याचा कवीने प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. हंगर कॅन मेक वन कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन मॉरल व्हॅल्यूज. नैतिक मूल्यांच्या बाबतीत आपल्याला तडजोड कधी कधी करावी लागते जेव्हा भुकेचा प्रश्न उपस्थित होतो. ह्युमन रिलेशनशिप, मानवी नाते अँड कंपिनियनशिप, मानवी सोबत, ही सुद्धा आपल्याला कधी कधी कॉम्प्रोमाइज करावं लागते, कधी कधी या गोष्टीमध्ये तडजोड करावा लागतो. दिस इज द अंडरलाईन लेसन ऑफ दिस पोएम. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द समरी ऑफ द पोएम हंगर. क्रिटिकल ॲप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द पोएम. वी आर नॉट गोईंग टू डिस्कस द पोएम लाईन बाय लाईन. जस्ट आय वुड लाईक टू क्रिटिसाइज द पोएम अँड दिस इज द क्रिटिकल ॲप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द पोएम हंगर. वेन यू विल गो थ्रू द टेक्स्ट ऑफ द पोएम, यू विल फाइंड दॅट दॅट इज नथिंग बट द इन्सिडेंट अँड द चेन ऑफ इन्सिडेंट दॅट टेक्स प्लेस हियर. वॉट हॅपन्स, लेट अस सी. क्रिटिकल ॲप्रिसिएशन इन पब्लिश इन 1976. हंगर इज पब्लिश इन 1976. इट एस्टॅब्लिश महापात्रा एज वन ऑफ द एमिनंट पोएट्स इन इंडियन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. याच्याबद्दल आपण बोललेलो आहोत. या कवितेने कवीला एक मानाचं स्थान भारतीय साहित्य विश्वामध्ये मिळवून दिलेलं आहे. हंगर एक्सप्लोर्स द थीम ऑफ सेक्स ट्रेड, पॉवर्टी अँड इमोशनल व्हॅक्युम. ह्या तीन गोष्टी आपण लक्षात ठेवायच्या आहेत. सेक्स ट्रेड म्हणजे वेश्याव्यवसाय, पॉवर्टी दारिद्र्य, अँड इमोशनल व्हॅक्युम, एक भावनिक अशा प्रकारची पोकळी. या सगळ्या वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारच्या थीम अतिशय प्रभावीपणे या कवितेमध्ये मांडलेल्या आपल्याला दिसतात आहे. इन महापात्रा सोन वर्ड्स, महापात्रांचे प्रत्यक्ष शब्द आहेत, ते म्हणतात, इन हंगर आय वॉज रायटिंग फ्रॉम माय एक्सपिरियन्स. मी जणू काय हे सगळं अनुभवलेलं असं ते म्हणतात. बट ही नेवर कमेंटेड वेदर द प्रोटॅगॉनिस्ट वॉज ही ऑर एनीबडी एल्स. देर इज द प्रोटॅगॉनिस्ट इन द पोएम, बट वी कांट से दॅट द प्रोटॅगॉनिस्ट वॉज जयंत महापात्रा ऑर नॉट. बट इट इज सेड बाय द पोएट दॅट ही वॉज रायटिंग फ्रॉम हिज एक्सपिरियन्स. मुव्हिंग ऑन, what happens into the poem, the fisherman is ready. So first character in the poem is obviously the protagonist, the poet, and the fisherman. The second character is fisherman. He is ready to let the narrator have sex with the 15-year-old daughter in exchange of pure peace. So this shows how the difficult plight of that fisherman and his daughter is. So there is an exchange of pure peace, and in exchange what the fisherman is going to do, that fisherman is going to sell his daughter to any person. So this is a very difficult situation that faces by the fisherman in his life due to poverty that he has been experiencing, and he is ready to give daughter to anyone who comes to him or who approaches him for the sake of sex. Here the tragedy does not lie in the transaction, but the casual acceptance in the transaction. This is a minute observation. See, the fisherman says, will you have her? So this is a very casual acceptance, casual approach of the fisherman, the father of that girl. And he is ready to give the daughter to anyone. So this is the tragedy. And this tragedy is very much there into the opening lines of this poem. Whereas the narrator deprived of emotional support. He has not emotional support, and that is love or womanly warmth, despite of his disliking, had sex with the young girl. But he felt hunger there, the other one, the fish slithering, turning inside. This is the last line of the fourth stanza, and we find that when he approaches that girl, and at the end he realizes that he felt hunger there. So at the end we find that then there is another hunger, and he felt the hunger there. The other one, the fish slithering, turning inside. These are the poetic devices, images used by the poet into the poem. Moving on, the fisherman and his daughter were poor. That's the obvious thing that we can see over here, that they are very poor, and in order to kill their hunger of food, this is the first hunger, that is hunger of food, father is ready to sell his daughter to satiate the hunger of the narrator. That is the hunger of the society. On another hand, the narrator, the poet itself, deprived of emotional support, bent down to buy the flesh or warmth of a girl. But in the end, he realized the hunger of the poor girl is much greater than his hunger that we discussed just now. Antim kshani kavicha lakshat yeta, narrator cha he lakshat yeta, ki tya mulichi ji bhook ahe, ti aplya bhookepeksha moti ahe. लैंगिक गरजेपेक्षा तिच्या पोटाची भूक ही मोठी आहे. दिस रिअलायझेशन द पोएट रिअलायझेस ॲट द एंड ऑफ द पोएम. बट इन द रियल वर्ल्ड नो बडी थिंक्स इन दॅट वे. पण असं म्हटलं गेलं की प्रत्यक्ष जीवनामध्ये असं फार कमी घडतं. स्पीकर हिमसेल्फ फाइंड्स बिफोर अ फिशरमन हु इज विलिंग टू कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन हिज डॉटर. दिस कॉम्प्रोमाइज इज इम्पॉर्टंट इन दिस पोएम. हर इंडिव्हिज्युअलिटी वॉज डाउनग्रेडेड अँड नो सिग्निफिकन्स ऑफ द विल. खरं तर ज्या स्त्रीच्या बाबतीत हे सगळं घडत आहे, ज्या मुलीच्या बाबतीत हे सगळं घडत आहे, तिच्या व्यक्तिमत्वाला इथे कुठेही किंमत दिसत नाही आहे आपल्याला आणि तिचं काही महत्त्व नाही आहे या कवितेमध्ये. ट्रेलिंग द नेट सिम्बॉलाइज अ नेट फॉर कस्टमर्स. द टर्मिनॉलॉजी हॅज बीन यूज इन द ओपनिंग लाईन्स ऑफ दिस पोएम. ट्रेलिंग द नेट्स, दिस इज द सिम्बॉल ऑफ द नेट फॉर द कस्टमर्स. ग्राहकांना जाळ्यात ओढण्यासाठी जणू काही त्यांनी जाळं तयार केलं आहे असा त्याचा एक सिम्बॉल आपण त्याचा अर्थ आपण घेऊ शकतो. द पोएम इज कॉमेंट्री ऑन अवर सोसायटी वेअर 15-year-old गर्ल इज यूज टू सॅटिएट द हंगर ऑफ सो कॉल्ड मॉरलिस्टिक अँड सिव्हिलाइज सोसायटी. दिस इज द ट्रॅजेडी ऑफ अवर सोसायटी दॅट द गर्ल विच इज नॉट इवन मॅच्युअर गर्ल, शी इज जस्ट 15 years अँड दिस गर्ल इज यूज बाय द फादर टू सॅटिएट द हंगर ऑफ सो कॉल्ड मॉरलिस्टिक अँड सिव्हिलाइज सोसायटी. उंड इज द टर्म यूज इन टू द पोएम. सो दिस इज अगेन द सिम्बॉल. Wound symbolizes the body of the girl as well as pill and hurting heart of the fisherman, where the narrator goes following fisherman and the hut, that hut is very filthy and hurting. So wound is the symbol of the body of the girl as well as the hut because it is very filthy and hurting. The filthy interior of the hut increases poet's uneasiness. Moving on, fisherman sold his daughter for their livelihood. This is the reason that he is selling. Poverty is the reason. He becomes a pimp for his daughter, as if he is a pimp. It is a shame on the society. It is a stigma on the human mind and his dreadful action. हा आपल्या समाजावर असलेला एक कलंक आहे. दारिद्र्य हा समाजावर असलेला एक कलंक आहे. In reality, nobody thinks of others. Lastly, to conclude, the poet understood the real meaning of the word hunger, the hunger of the miserable poverty. या कवितेच्या अंतिम क्षणी आपल्याला दिसतं की खरी जी भूक आहे ती भूक पोटाची आहे. त्या मुलीच्या पोटात पडलेली आग ज्या आगेसमोर कवीच्या मनामध्ये असलेली जी भूक आहे ती लहान होते. द हंगर ऑफ द मिझरेबल पॉवर्टी द डॉमिनेट्स द फिजिकल हंगर ऑफ द पोएट. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द पोएम हंगर रिटन बाय जयंत महापात्रा. बॉयज अँड गर्ल्स, I would like to suggest that you should go through the poem many times and try to understand the meaning of the poem. I hope you have understood this poem. In the coming lectures, we are going to discuss the next part of our syllabus. So thank you for your kind listening. Thank you.